called the image of perfection. In the beginning, God created man and woman in his image. In Genesis chapter 1, 26, it says, "And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness." And verse 27 said, "So God created man in his own image. Of God created he, him, male and female, created them." So God created Adam and Eve. He created a marriage. In his image, he did not put Adam and Eve here in sin. He created marriage. So you now, you are the image of perfection. The image of the Almighty. To show just how much, when it all started, there were God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. They are completely different, but yet the same. So for God to create an image of himself, he had to create a trinity. A husband, a wife, and God. And you can say that he only created man and woman, but like I said, he created marriage. And for a successful marriage to work, it has to have God. So he created a trinity in marriage. A man, a woman, and God. You are now the image of the Alpha and the Omega. You are the image of God. So don't take the covenant you made lightly. So when people see your marriage, they are looking at a picture of God. You can see marriage as a tool from God to save lost souls. For example, if someone asks you, "How do I find God? What does God want from me? And what does he need from me?" And you will tell them that God wants a personal relationship with them. He wants a covenant. Then they will ask, "What is a covenant?" And you can say, like marriage. So the question is, will you take your marriage and allow God to shine through you as a couple to the point that the other person wants the covenant with God? This is why marriage is so important and was also made in his image. So to let him shine through your marriage, let's look into the book. In Ephesians, it shows us how to do this. It shows us that the male represents Christ and the female represents the church. And I'm going to read from Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 5, 20. "Giving thanks always for all the things unto God and unto the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Submitting yourself one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourself unto your husband as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. And he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water of the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot, wrinkle, or any such thing, that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought man that love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever hated his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, even as the Lord and church. For we are members of the body of his flesh and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, shall be joined unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. This is the great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in part and particular so love his wife, even as himself, and his wife see that she reverence her husband." Now and there we learn that not only are you the image of God, but also the image of the church and the love he had for the church. So now you know you are the image of God and his church. Clint, you are representing Christ now. So love her like Christ loved the church. So when God looks in, he is pleased with your marriage, and it is without blemish. And if you do that, she will not have a problem giving you her everything. And Abigail, you are now representing the church. So surrender yourself unto him, and he shall love you as Christ loves his church. Now that is a love that people will want, and that will guide people unto Christ. I love you both, and pray for your marriage, and that you use this tool to help save this lost world. Just remember to individually grow your personal relationship with Christ, and also grow your relationship with Christ together. I will stop with this. In James chapter 1, it says, be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to get angry. So always listen to one another. Let things go, and not everything needs something said. And most importantly, find Christ in everything. I love you.